to Two Rod Highway.
Turn right.
today by visiting stone.edu to apply for our upcoming classes. Mammography isn't what it used to be. At Jefferson Radiology, advances in technology mean fewer callbacks, more accurate readings, and finally, some peace of mind.
I believe in this. I think it's like 98% accurate all the time. 98% is good. It's high percentage. So this is what we're going to do, Tessa. We're going to call your boyfriend, Brett. We're going to offer him roses. You know how it works. He'll be listening in. You can, like, jump in on the conversation and chat with him if you want. You can confront him, or you don't have to if you're uncomfortable, okay?
Okay.
Hang tight, Tessa. We're going to call Tessa's boyfriend, Brett. We'll do that next.
Wait,
Man, this light's long. Has that big building on the left, right there, right there. Yeah.
Which one?
Right, yeah, right there.
That
yeah.
one.
Yep.
The destination is on your left. 233 Main Street.
Yeah.
No.
Right there.
Arrived.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Have a good day. Yeah, Lewis, right?
Yeah.
How you doing, man?
How you doing? Are you from group at 10?
Yeah. Nice. Nice sweater, man.
Oh, thanks. My girl made it, too. Yeah, I feel way better.
All right. Hey, man. How you doing?
What up?
What's going on,
man? You been drinking your soup?
A lot of vitamins and...
Yeah. And your ginger ale?
Yeah, my ginger and stuff like that, yeah.
That's up. Well, we get everything prepared and then I'll take you guys in a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you have the clue? Yeah. I caught it really from my roommate because he had it. And then I started getting it, but I started making remedies, drinking a lot of vitamins.
Yeah, it's the cold weather.
He still got it. I said, I don't got it no more. I told you, drink the remedies that I drink, and you're going to see it's going to go away.
Yeah, Campbell's soup is good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Put some crackers and rich crackers and vegetables.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Everybody's trying to get that PlayStation 5, huh?
Yeah, or Xbox. Wow. Yeah,
I've got the PlayStation 5 already. I'm trying to get the new Xbox. My boy got it in Plainville.
Yeah, they're restocking. They're restocking at like Walmart, GameStop. Mm-hmm. Ran out of chips last year.
Yeah, I already got the PlayStation 5, and I got the old Xbox 360.
Hey,
I got the PlayStation 4, but I got it inside the room.
Oh, did you see the Xbox anniversary, the 20th anniversary?
The new one?
Well, they showed, they have a backwards compatibility, so they added 90 games from Xbox 360 to play Xbox One.
Oh, that's not bad, man. Mm-hmm. So he got the new one that came out, so I'm going to see how much it is.
Yeah, there's websites that is like $200, like not really cheap.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Trying to get one, yeah.
I got it for what? $150?
Yeah.
$150, I got mine.
That's good price.
Yeah, so remote control, all the bad. I got like 15 games already?
Yeah.
But I get it through him. I'd rather go through him. Oh, he got Call of Duty over there. I'm getting it next week. I go through him, I get it dirt cheap. I go to Walmart and all these places, it was $60, $50, $40 for one game. When I could get it from him, I could get it for $15, $20 tops. Instead of paying $40, $50 for a game of $60.
Yeah. GameStop could rip off too.
Yeah, I only bought one game there, and it was for my girl. And she wanted the Assassin's Creed. And I was looking everywhere, and they had it there. So I said, I'm not going nowhere. Here you go. Let me get that game, bro. Never again.
Yeah, they don't even let you go dumpster diving anymore. Like, it's illegal.
Oh.
They said, but some people still do it. They throw out, like, used games, but they're still good. They did. And you can sell it back. They throw out good stuff. Sometimes, just like Dunkin' Donuts throws out.
Yeah, I had a place in Hartford, but my boy used to work there. Like I say, you're through the nighttime, go through the back, and I'm gonna give you all type of chicken and muffins and all that stuff. Kentucky Fried Chicken. Man, I used to have a bag like this. I'm not. By the time that he told me, he comes out through the back, put the bag closed. He goes back in, like, man, I got mac and chicken fried chicken, biscuits, everything up in there.
Free food?
Yeah, free food. You can't beat that. It's fresh, and it's still going to throw it out. It's in the front. They just put it in the back and throw it out. He puts it in a little bucket, real nice and neat.
I wish I lived close by next to one.
Yeah. The farthest one I like that I used to live in Hartford, and it's far, man. So you got to have a car or a bike. I used to have a big mutton bike.
Yeah.
So I grab a book bag and go over there and buy what I gotta buy and come back. But I'm thinking right now either buy me a car, either a car or a motorcycle. I'm going for them two right now.
Yeah, motorcycles are dangerous.
Oh, I've been driving motorcycles since I was.
Oh, really? I like mopeds.
Yeah, I was gonna think about buying one and I was like, there's a lot of stealing of them things. People stealing mopeds left and right. But I got a place already to put it in my sister. If I do buy my sister's garage, ain't nobody gonna walk in there.
I want a truck. I'm tired of driving cars. I want a nice car van.
Mm-hmm.
U-Haul truck. I drove one time a U-Haul truck.
Yeah, my friend bought one. He bought one. He goes to auctions. He buys the cars for dirt cheap. He paints them. He fix them up and sell them for $1,000 or something. Go back, get two cars, do it again. He got a house. He got a U-Haul truck. He got a big SUV. I'd be like, man, you're making money doing that. He flips it. Buy for less, flips it. Buy for less, flips it. That's good money, though.
Must have a good job.
Yeah, he works in construction, sheetrocking, and all that stuff. He gets paid pretty good, though. Plus, his wife works. It's like a social worker.
You have kids?
Oh, me, I got three.
Wow.
Got an 18-year-old, I can't believe it. Got an 18-year-old, then my daughter.
Wow, you look young.
And then my other daughter, she's about to be 6 or 7. That's the baby.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't want no more. The girl that I'm with right now, she wants one. And I tell her, not right now, bro. I'm not feeling it right now. I'm paying child support as it is, I said. Every week, I work. But these days, I don't work. Okay, so the days that I'm working, man.
It takes a lot.
Yeah.
About 10 o'clock
with Emma?
With
Emma?
Yeah.
Okay. Is the bathroom over there?
Mm-hmm. That's what I just said. I said I gotta use the bathroom before I go in.
Yeah.
Thank you. need new heroes suited for the times we're in.
I don't know what to expect.
Disappear. I just hate that. That's the way I play 100% all the time. Baseball was life. We all lived together in the neighborhood for a couple of more years, mostly through junior high school. Every summer was great, but none of it ever came close to that first one. When one guy would move away, they never replaced him on the team with anyone else. He just kept the game going, like he was still there.
Wow.
It was weird, but Ben had said Babe Ruth was like the main of baseball. Name ended up being Hercules. None of us could ever figure out what that meant, but what we were all amazed by. I kept in touch with those guys over the years, and I found out that Yaya's parents shipped him off to military school. After the Army, he became one of the pioneering developers of bungee jumping, which we all know well. Bertram got really into the 60s, and no one ever saw him again. He was an architect and a contractor. They started out small, designing playground equipment and prefabricated tree houses. Squints grew up and married Wendy Pepperdine. They have 9 kids. They bought Vincent's drugstore and they still own it to this day. Hamilton Porter became a professional. You know him as the great Campino. The Nunes played AAA ball, but he never got the pay. He owns his own business now and coaches a little league team that his son's playing called the Heaters. Hercules lived to be 199 years old in dog years. I was the last one. But when I did, the Sandlot was still there. After Benny came to the beast, his reputation spread all over town. From then on, he was known as Benny, the Jet, door to the left.
Eventful.
Eventful one?
Yeah.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Mixture.
Let's see how everybody's doing physically, mentally, and the question of the day is, what are you guys looking forward to at the end of the week?
Like, who's starting?
Scale 1 to 10?
If you have, like, anything planned, or, like, what do you want to set for yourself by the end of the week?
Probably apply to more jobs.
Okay.
Yeah. Online.
Yeah, how you doing physically?
Okay.
Mentally? How you feeling?
Doing okay, alright. Not perfect, yeah.
How did the order go?
How you doing physically, mentally?
I'm in a little pain. My foot's in pain when it gets cold or when it rains. I have a bad foot that I need to get fixed, but they won't do it until I cut the weight down.
Mm-hmm.
So it's hard. Mentally, I'm like an 8. You know, I'm feeling good.
Okay.
I got a little, I'm actually down a little bit because I'm worried about one of my friends, but... Kind of worried about them.
It's always good to, keep your head up, stay strong for them. The best thing you can do for anybody is, trying to stay positive.
Yeah. Looking forward to being alive, thanking God.
Mm.
That I have issues, but I still give it to God, No matter what I go through, even if I'm doing wrong, I still acknowledge Him, And that's, I'm trying to find my way, navigate my way through life without being too, letting it bother me so much.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it.
It's great to hear, man. Make those goals, keep them up. Somebody's next.
doing good. Trying to keep my head up. Trying to move where I'm at right now. You know, but it's hard. As soon as they check the background and stuff like that. You got the money, but they don't care at the end of the day. So, but I've been doing good and stuff like that. Next week, I'm going to go and see this car.
Okay.
If I like it, I'm going to buy it because I'm tired of walking and riding bikes. So, it's a 2004 Lexus.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, so I'm going to go and check it out and stuff like that. If I like it, I don't really want that type of car. The car that I want, they got it across the street.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the one I want. It's a two-door, small. I could hook it up the way I want. It already got rims. But I'm gonna go and see it just to see it and stuff like that. If I like it, I'll probably get it or not. I'm debating right now.
It's getting cold outside, you know.
Yeah. Thinking about that or 4x4. It's a 4x4, I will not get stuck.
Yeah.
If you get a little small car, you're gonna get stuck.
Yeah.
You know, if I get a big boy, you know, I'm not gonna get stuck.
Yeah, all wheel drive. You know? Mm-hmm. Push through snow. That's dope. That's dope. Hopefully, you know, it works out for you.
Mm-hmm.
You get that going.
Yeah.
How about you, Enrique?
Physically, somewhat okay. Last week when I started walking every day, eventually my legs just put so much on the glutes that just felt pain on Wednesday.